Starting with 16.1, the DX Toolbar, DX Data Grid, DX Menu, and DX Form are optimized for use on mobile devices and support different screen sizes. To demonstrate the native look appearance, I'll use the DevExtreme simulator. New capabilities include a compact drop-down DX Toolbar menu, which is used to switch a view instead of tabs. The DX Data Grid now provides a context menu optimized for small screen resolutions. Now you can expand and collapse groups using a mouse click or tap. Group rows using the context menu. And select columns using checkboxes displayed within the column chooser. The DX Scheduler now provides the agenda view that can be set as a default for small screen sizes. The DX Menu adapts its layout to change the screen resolution. DX form items can be shown with different column numbers on different screen sizes. In this video, we'll cover all the basics of configuring the DevExtreme widgets for work on mobile devices and different screen sizes. I've already created a basic DevExtreme application, added the DX Data Grid widget, defined data for it, and set some options to enable grid interactivity. The DX Data Grid's data displays information on customers. Let's see how the widget looks with the specified data and settings. The DX Data Grid renders tabs for the toolbar panel for iPad and a compact drop-down menu instead of tabs. I can select columns using checkboxes displayed within the column chooser. The DevExtreme Data Grid can adapt its layout to narrow screens. If screen width is not wide enough to display all columns, the widget hides them according to the specified priority. To enable this capability, I'll set the Column Hiding Enabled option to true. I'll also set the order of hiding grid columns when the widget adapts to the screen size. I'll use the Column Hiding Priority option to do this. Now let's see the result in the browser. To view values of hidden columns, I'll click the ellipsis button in the last column of the required row. Columns were hidden according to the Column Hiding Priority value. I'll type the text in the search box. The grid searches for data inside hidden columns as well. To make grouping rows convenient on mobile devices, I'll enable a group context menu by defining the grouping.contextMenuEnabled option. I'll also allow end users to group and expand rows on a row click and set the groupPanel.visible option to auto to hide a group panel for small screen sizes automatically. And let's see the result. Now you can expand and collapse groups using a mouse click or tap, group and ungroup rows using a context menu, and as you may notice, the toolbar items are moved to the drop-down menu when there is not enough space for them. Now I'll add a grid pager and set the page size to 5. And let's see the result again. I switch from iPad to iPhone to show you how the pager has changed. You can easily access it even on small devices. I'll add several DX command widgets and run the application in a browser. The application toolbar doesn't look very good, so let's improve the appearance. I'll hide some toolbar items if there's not enough space for them. To do this, I'll set the Locate in Menu option to auto for the required items. And here we are. Now it looks much better. I've also added the scheduler view with the DX scheduler widget. define data for the widget, and set some options. The DX Scheduler's resources display information on appointments, tasks, events, and other similar data. The DX Data Grid's data displays information on customers. Let's see what the widget looks like with the specified data and settings. The scheduler shows a built-in date navigator, a views drop-down selector, and a timetable. I can edit appointments by bringing up a pop-up detail window. Now let's modify the scheduler by setting the view option based on the screen size. To do this, I'll handle the view shown event and set the scheduler views collection and the current view based on the device type. Now the scheduler renders views according to the device type. All right, next, let's see how to tune up the DX menu to adapt its layout to changing the screen resolution. I've already added the DX menu to the menu page and specified its data source. And let's see what it looks like with the specified data. And you can see not all items are shown on the iPhone. So let's improve this behavior. To enable adaptive widget rendering on a small screen, I'll set the Adaptivity Enabled option to true. And let's see the results again. Now the DX menu has a more compact representation and I can access all the menu items. Finally, I'll show you how to set up the DX form layout for mobile devices. I've already added the DX form widget to the form page and defined data for it. And let's see what the widget looks like with the specified data on devices with different screen resolutions. And as you can see, the DX form has the same layout for all devices. Let's improve that. Starting with 16.1, the DX form allows you to specify dependency between the screen factor and the count of columns in the form layout. I'll use the call count by screen configuration object for this and set the column count to 2 for large, middle-sized, and small screens, and set the column count to 1 for small-sized screens. And let's look again. Now the DX form renders a different layout for different mobile devices. And that's it. To learn more about DevExtreme widgets and how to customize them, please refer to the documentation on our website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.